Stay tuned for tonight's adventure with the Fat Man.
Okay, here we go. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whatever time of day it is. I hope it's good to be where you are, because I'm really excited to be here today. My name is Baltimore Fats, and this is Solid Goal. Yeah! Okay, so the Intrepid Mr. X has to do a social studies report every week and on a current event. And this is one of the sources that we use for that. And he left it up on my laptop last night, so it was the first thing I saw this morning. And the top headline here is, scientists use plastic to create lightweight 18-karat gold. And I read that, I was like, that's amazing. That's alchemy. How many problems could this solve? I mean, it could solve the world financial crisis. It could solve the recycling crisis. So I wanted to read this article. I was like, well, I got to find out about this, right? And the article starts with how much everybody loves gold, of course, but just how darn heavy it is. Gold is so heavy. If only we had a more lightweight gold. And so this team of researchers in Zurich has created one, right? And they did it by mixing gold nanocrystals with protein fibers, polymer latex, water, and salt to create a gel. They then replaced the water with alcohol and placed the gel inside a high-pressure carbon dioxide chamber. The reaction transformed the golden plastic into a light aerogel that could be heated and melt and molded to whatever form was necessary. The gold has the material properties of a plastic. Or, even more, the plastic has assumed the material properties of the gold. Right? In addition to being lighter, it has other advantages over traditional forms of gold, right? Because it has a much lower melting point, and so therefore it's much easier to work with, and you can change the density of it just by, you know, tweaking your recipe. You know, it talks about how you can get different colors and everything like that within the matrix. So they published their study and how they were able to do this in this advanced functional materials, and I have it pulled up. We'll look at it briefly, right? And they say that they expect that this new lightweight gold will be able to replace the metallic version in most traditional applications, including jewelry and watches, but it's going to be a hard sell because buyers associate high-quality gold with weight. But the material will undoubtedly be beneficial for use inside electronic devices, chemical catalysts, and even radiation shielding. And now when I read that and thinking about nanoparticles and gold and being able to manufacture or create your own gold at will, this is renewable gold we're talking about here. It made me think about, you know, Zechariah, Ascension, and the 12th planet, and how Nibiru came here looking to replace the, you know, or use the gold from our Earth to create a shield for their atmosphere. You know, I think that's kind of a very interesting connection to kind of make with this. Although, again, I'm not so sold on the ancient astronaut theory as I once was, you know, coming to flat Earth and the enclosed system. But, you know, it's still a very interesting topic, and who knows? I don't know. We're all right. We're all wrong. You know, I don't know. But it's interesting to think about, and especially for the use of, you know, in electronic devices and so forth, and in chemical catalysts. But one thing that really sparked my attention when I read this was how they did it. They said here that they mixed gold nanocrystals with protein fibers. And when I read that, I was like, well, first I didn't know what a gold nanocrystal was, and we're going to look at that too. But a protein, that's living material, right? It's any class of nitrogenous organic compounds that consist of large molecules composed of one or more long chains of amino acids, an essential part of all living organisms. So essentially what they're saying is that they're grafting gold nanoparticles onto a living protein, right? Because when I looked up what gold nanoparticles were, I mean, not only that, you can buy them, which is awesome, right? But this is gold nanocrystal in overview, so I figured that was a good place to start. And of course, it's extremely technical. Yeah, you know, I can't really, you know, it hurts the brain to go through this. And believe me, I read most of it. But, you know, it's gold on a micro scale. All right. And so as I was continuing to read and getting frustrated that I, you know, I was not really capable of understanding the chemistry and all of that, I see this. It says gold nanocrystals with DNA-directed morphologies in nature communications. And so now it really got me going on the, Well, if they're grafting these gold nanoparticles onto living protein fibers, and their DNA directed morphologies, that's what they're doing. They're essentially growing the gold into the plastic, is the best way that I can, you know. Please, someone tell me if I'm wrong about this concept, but this is what, while reading this stuff, is the best I can kind of get out of it. And they never, in reading all of this, they never talk about what DNA they use to do this gold growing on. They just don't. Right, but here it is, and, you know, it's hard to even get more phallic than this, right? You know, and here it is growing in its petri dish or whatever. You know, boy, is it growing. Right? They never talk about what DNA strand they use, you know, or what protein it is that they're using to grow this gold on. It's not mentioned in here that I could find, perhaps in one of the many long footnotes it is, but certainly just reading through this, I could not find what DNA strand they were growing it on. And so I think that's really amazing. I mean, they really are making this plastic gold, where they're changing plastic into gold. You know, and it made me think about what is gold as we know it. It's an element. I had it brought up, but I'm not going to do it. It's an element. It occurs naturally in solid form in rocks and nuggets and veins and so forth. And, you know, it has many different properties. It's extremely high melting point. It doesn't dissolve easily in any acids or other solvents. And, you know, it's one of the most precious metals on the planet. So many economies are were at least one time based on gold before they turned it to imaginary paper. And now they have plastic that's gold and can be used in all the same ways that gold is used. And thinking about what the value system of gold and how could they have been doing this for a long time. And I'm sure, you know, because I've known about this since I was a teenager, you know, the Baghdad Battery. And what the Baghdad Battery did. You know, they found these things a long time ago. And some theorize that it could be used to create an electric charge. And some have gone as far as to say that they use this to electroplate things and to make them appear gold when they weren't gold. You know, and that could be an explanation for a lot of the golden relics, especially in Pharaoh's tombs and stuff like that. But it also makes it really easy to fake that stuff. You know, as perhaps a lot of those tombs were staged finds and the treasures were staged and that they were electroplated, perhaps not by the Baghdad Battery. But it's nice to have the Baghdad Battery in the pocket for when someone down the line may discover, yeah, this isn't actually solid gold. I think this was electroplated. Well, you know, they had that technology then. They could electroplate. Oops, our bad. You know, and so, you know, I think that's a really amazing story that they're growing gold on DNA, which is, of course, what the end game of the spectroscopy has been, the manipulation of DNA, and they wouldn't be able to do this without spectroscopy. And that's going to come up further, and it's really kind of coincidental that just finding this article brought up on my laptop this morning, you know, finds a way to actually connect itself to the project that I've been working on, which is Heart of Glass Part 3. And I'm sorry it's taken so long to get out there, guys. I do have a part of it already recorded, but it's kind of a big story, and I kind of want to put it all out at the same time. And so it's nice to find this as a little holdover episode. And I hope you guys enjoyed this one. I had a lot of fun bringing it to you this morning. I'm glad I could get one out. And so until the next one, cheers, guys.